this morning's quarter final between James Bissett and Sean Budd, with James making 133 break. That obviously goes up onto YouTube, so you can go and watch that if you missed it live here this morning. It's youtube.com/cueballtv, or you can find it through the ABSC website. It's a fantastic service that is provided in part by the ABSC, but also the events are providing funding for it. I'll introduce our matches this afternoon. The semi-finals are the best of nine frames. So there'll be a break after four frames, or if the player gets to 3-0. On table two, an all WA affair, with Matthew Bolton up against Peter McCullagh. The referee is Janine Rawlings. Here on table three, it's called New South Wales affair. Well, formerly New South Wales, now South Australia, Sean Budd. New South Wales, Richard Perry. The referee for that match is Ben Keane. With that, remind everybody, please make sure your phones are on silent. Wish the players the best of luck. Put you in the hands of referees and get the matches underway.
West Coast International Snooker semi-final for 2016. Two West Australians here, Peter McCullagh and Matthew Bolton. And McCullagh there with the opening red. These two players, a rematch of the West Australian State Snooker Championships last week, won by Matthew Bolton. Both players relatively untroubled in getting to the semi-finals. Matthew Bolton defeating Barry Saxon in the quarterfinals, 4-1, including the then highbreak of the tournament of 1-1-3. Looks well positioned here. A few loose reds. Looking to make the first telling contribution of the semi-final. good opportunity here for Bolton. Black and pink both in play, blue on its spot, a few loose reds. Failing to capitalise there on an early opportunity brings McCullagh back to the table. Throughout the tournament, Peter McCullagh yet to drop a frame, winning both his matches 4-0. Also held the high break at 101 after the first day. As mentioned, Norwest Australian affair here. Both players based in Perth. In the other semi-final, it's Eastern States contenders Sean Budd and Richard Perrick. Budd coming through a high-quality quarter-final match against James Mifflin, winning in the final frame on a black ball game. Opening red by Peter McCullagh leaves himself nicely on the black. Opportunity lost there for McCullagh, concentrated more on going into the reds and took his eye off the black. Chance here for Bolton. For a safety, and that's a good one. Tough to pick a winner out of these two. Both can make frame-winning contributions at any visit. in last week's state title. Bolton raced to a 3-frame-to-0 lead, led 4-1 at the interval. Before McCullagh won the next three, they split the next two, and Bolton won a tight deciding frame. Great long red by Bolton there. Tried to get him behind the blue, but slightly overrun. McCullagh looking at a pot. He'd wait for a better opportunity. A little bit of safety exchange here. The semi-final to be played out at the best of 9 frames. Key is winning the last frame, but it's always nice to get the first frame up on the board. Opportunity for Bolton here. Just needs a good position shot off the green. Probably needs one of the loose reds on the side cushion. Thank you. could just go up into the two reds above the black. Well played. Matthew's break now totaling 24. As mentioned, we'll need one of the two reds that's on the side cushion to leave McCullagh needing snookers in this first frame. Red and a colour will leave McCullagh leading snookers. Rolls the black in and sits nicely on the last remaining red. Break of 40 there from Matthew Bolton. McCullagh back to the table, needing two snookers. Matthew Bolton, the defending champion here at the West Coast International. Do you want to have a go? Gotta get his first snooker. Not a difficult one to get out of. Difficult queuing here from McCullagh now. Good attempt there by Bolton, but I think McCullagh can just get past the brown. Mm-hmm. against Snooker, but not a difficult one to get out of. Balls are well placed for Snookers with the brown and blue, both just off the cushion. Gives McCullagh a target. Surely Matthew will take this on. Sits over the pocket, and surely this is the frame for Matthew Bolton. McCullagh won't get out of his chair. Should this break come to an end? One, two. Just an opportunity to have some long potting practice. So Bolton takes the early lead, 1-0. 64-14. I think the last time I looked, Bolton was ranked number 2 in Australia for snooker, and Peter McCullagh number 11. I think living in the West could have an effect on Peter McCullagh's ranking. Here we see on the screen now the results from round one. Brian Howell over Narelle Adams 4-1. Ben Foster 4-0 against Jeremy Giannani. Viet Thai in a seventh frame decider against Eddie McCoffey 4-3. Kyle Rendon 4-1 over Adam Wyatt. Steve Maynard 4-2. John Siddons. Janine Rawlings 4-0. Our referee today in the semi-finals. John Harris beating Mark Clem 4-2. And Mark Devlin over Ali Bakker 4-3. Round 2 saw Matthew Bolton defeat Brian Howe 4-0. Baden Dewey overcoming Neville Lovers 4-3. Lovers making the semi-finals of the state title last week. Barry Saxon 4-3 win over Michael Hoff. Craig Turner 4-2 over Ben Foster. McCullagh 4-0 over Viet Thai. Vince Lawson, Clint Franey and Ben Judge winning their respective round 2 clashes. Ryan Thomason, one of the Eastern States players, beating Steve Maynard 4-0. Chris Carter over Kishan Bhavnani 4-1. Gordon Whittaker 4-3 over Wayne Rawlings. Semi-finalist Richard Perich 4-0 over Janine Rawlings. Wins also for Shannon Dixon, Sean Budd, Ben Keane and James Mifsud. The last 16 played yesterday afternoon. Matthew Bolton 4-1 over Baden Dewey. Barry Saxon, a winner again, 4-2 over Craig Turner. McCullagh, a comfortable 4-0 win, as with Ben Judge. Frame 2, Matthew Bolton to break. Perhaps a little fortunate not to leave one on here. Thank you. containing safety running into the balls there. McCullagh very impressive in his semi quarterfinal win over Ben Judge, 4-0. Those two also played in the semi-final of the state title the previous week, which went the distance, with McCullagh winning 4-3. Like there with the opening red on the second frame. The other semi-final on table three, Sean Budd took the opening frame against Richard Perrick. He's currently at the table on a break of 15. Safety by McCullagh. Good opening red there by Bolton. Leaves himself nicely on the black. Just nudge away one of the reds. Still a few reds away from making this a frame-winning opportunity. Up a little short of that red. I'll have to go down for the blue or one of the pork colours. Fine position shot there. A couple of loose reds to play for. Sean Budd currently on a 51 break on table three as he looks to go two frames ahead against Richard Perrick. queuing here, Matthew Bolton. Well, I was in the break, the red to keep the break going. Currently at 30. Tough to see his next red after this black. Nudges one away. It's on with a thin cut. And the break falls down at 37. Safety here for McCullagh. Who took the red on? That's why I'm sitting behind the camera. Long red available here from Peter McCullagh. The other semi-final, Sean Budd takes a 2-frame-to-0 lead. Opportunity there for McCullagh. It was a tough long red. Leaves Matthew with a choice of reds. A run through on this red or a cue back. Goes up for the blue. Good opportunity here for Matthew to take this second frame. Speaking with Peter McCullagh before the game, talking about what a tough competitor Matthew Bolton is. Seven. Room past the yellow for this red. Should watch a bit closer because he was going for the yellow. So So definitely room past the yellow this time. Still a bit of work to do here for Bolton to put this second frame out of reach. Center pocket here. Spin back for the black. Missed opportunity, but he's not left a red on. Bit fortunate there. Still 67 remaining on the table. That's still a bit to play for. Overruns that safety a little. Long red chance here for Bolton. Rattles that one home. Comes up nicely for the blue. Blue will put him 59 ahead with just 59 remaining. I'm sure McCullagh will stay in his seat when this visit breaks down. As in last week's semi-final of the state snooker, Matthew Bolton raced to an early lead, so McCullagh have to make another comeback.
Matthew Bolton, 30.
and Matthew Bolton leading the semi-final 2-0. No major contributions from either player so far, but the important score is 2 frames to Matthew Bolton. As we can see on the other table, Sean Budd at the table again, leading 2 frames to 0 over Richard Perrick. Probably a strong favourite in that game. Sean Budd, winner of multiple national ranking events, including the Australian National Snooker Championships. So McCullagh at the table here in the 3rd frame. Sean McCullagh will be looking to win this initial safety exchange, get the first opportunity in this 3rd frame. Is that safety a little bit short? Safety by Bolton, leaving McCullagh nestled up on the back cushion. Previous good safety has presented Matthew Bolton with an opportunity here in an opening red. It's a good chance here for Bolton. A number of loose reds. Black available into both corner pockets. Thank you. a very good opportunity here for Matthew to put a telling contribution in this third frame. Throughout the tournament, when he's been given an opportunity, he has been making some big breaks. In the quarterfinals, a 113, as well as a few 80s in the earlier rounds. How's his luck? Has he got the red below the pink in the center cushion, center pocket? He's got one loose red to the right. So needs a good pot here to continue the break. So Bolton makes a break of 29. Five. Just a safety here for McCullagh, no reds left on. Cue ball up behind the yellow. Very good safety. Probably just the one cushion escape, nestle into the group of five reds, just below the pink. I hope I get this one right. In the other semi-final, Sean Button racing to a 3-0 lead. Well played by Bolton, following my instruction there. I don't think Willie Thorne and Dennis Taylor have got anything to worry about though. They do have a wonder pen though, so. Good opening red for McCullagh. Very well respected player on the national circuit, Peter McCullagh. former professional snooker player from Dagenham in Essex. I think at last count, McCullagh had made 8 maximum breaks of 147. Very good snooker players coming from Essex. One of the best known, Steve Davis, Ronnie O'Sullivan, Stuart Bingham, Mark King, Joe Perry. Still a bit of work to do here for McCullagh. Aren't you better off being at the table? You can't win a frame from sitting down. Makes a tough long red, keeps a break going, 29 points apiece here. Just missed the edge of the reds there. So just a safety available for McCullagh now. Matthew Bolton tight against the back cushion. Oh, Paul picks out a nice plant there. It's obviously quite apparent that I'm more Hazel Irvin than Willie Thorne as a snooker commentator. So break moves on to 42 here for McCullagh. Again, looking to move a couple of reds off the side cushion to bring them into play. He had to do it. But it's opened the door again for Matthew Bolton. Hard to see him winning the frame from here. Thank you. could run through and dislodge one of the reds off the cushion. So as is often the case, the player tries to bring the tough remaining reds into play and miss the colour. A 4-point lead from McCullagh here. Fantastic long red from Bolton. Not a great deal of value in it though. It's gonna roll up behind the black. Got it nice and tight there. Needs a bit of luck here, McCullagh. Relatively easy to hit, but can he keep it safe? He's done well. Ball colours well positioned for a telling safety here from Matthew Bolton. Tries to get behind the black, just overruns it. As he left the red on. A chance here for Matthew Bolton. So a chance here now for Bolton. And they tore the colours up to and including the blue. Fantastic long putt there from Matthew Bolton. bad miss by Bolton, but he's got fortunate. As Peter McCullagh can see enough of the potting angle here. Could have been thrown a lifeline in this third frame. Get behind the black. It's a frame like this that can really turn the momentum. If McCullagh can pinch it after Bolton missed that the green earlier, it could give him a lot of confidence. Junior here, another long green. Almost got lucky. Slightly fortunate with where the green ended up. I'm joined here in commentary now by tournament director Adam Wyatt. Adam, so far another successful West Coast International.
Yeah, it's been great so far. Thanks for having me, Dan.
It's the first one I've been of living back in England for 9 years, and yeah, good to see that some of the Eastern States top-ranked players still supporting the event.
Yeah, this tournament's gone from strength to strength, really. So you're talking 9 years ago. That would have been when Neil Robertson was here making 147s.
Yeah, it was. I think that was three successive years that
That's right. He
won it, and with maximum breaks as the highest break.
And almost two in one match.
Yeah.
On one occasion.
So we've seen the success of Neil Robertson on the international stage, and you being well involved with Australian snooker, is there any other Australian players that could follow his lead and make a name for themselves in the international stage?
Well, we've now got Kurt Dunham, who's just joined the main tour and has played his first couple of qualifying events, but didn't manage to have any success there. We've also got Vinnie Calabrese on the main tour, but he's currently taking a bit of a break. He's back home in Australia at the moment. Peter used to compete on the professional circuit in the 90s, so about 20 years ago.
It's just getting tougher and tougher to make it with, you know, the dearth of Chinese players now, you know, who are almost at the level of, you know, the international calibre. Surely there's maybe an opportunity for like a second level professional tour with some lesser events.
Yeah, well, so you've got Chinese players coming through at 14 years of age now that can just pot anything on the table. And it's just incredible the way they've taken to the game. But so Peter at the table now with a chance to take the frame. There it is, 2-1.
So again, pinching those frames that could go either way could have a big deciding factor on the outcome of this game, because obviously in last week, Matthew raced to a 3-0 lead, Peter came back. Wouldn't like to see him do it twice in 2 weeks.
No, that's right. Yeah, really, at this level, anything can happen.
We see in the other semi-final, Sean Butch is breaking off in the fourth frame, leading 3-0. You know, hard to see Richard Barrett coming back in that one.
No, Sean's really dominated that match.
So as we can see here, the high break so far, so very high quality. As mentioned, McCullagh was the first to make a century, was beaten by Matthew Bolton, who made it 113, and when he finished that, James Mifsud was currently on his way to a 133, so again, very high quality stuff.
Matthew held the highest break for all of about 3 minutes.
But as he mentioned, he's not here to win the high break, he's here to win the tournament.
That's so right.
So if you can just tell us a little bit more about, you know, the current ranking system. You know, this tournament, obviously, not all of the top players come over.
No, but there are double ranking points available for this tournament. So it's basically as a way for the ABC to support this event and to make it attractive for players to come over. So we've always had strong support from the Eastern States players.
So Aaron Mahoney previously come over for the West Coast, but not visiting this year?
Not this year, yeah. The prize money is down a little bit this year, but it's still a quality event.
So as you can see, current semi-finalists Matthew Bolton and Sean Budd ranked 5 and 8, but Ryan Thomason there ranked number 2. Surprising loser of the quarterfinal.
Absolutely, yeah. I was refereeing on the next table, so I didn't get to see much of it. But what we're looking at here is the Reventon ranking list, which is where we have 9 selected events throughout the year, and your top 6 scores count. At the end of that, then 8 players will be top 6 on the Reventon rankings, plus the Australian Under 21 champion. And a wildcard player will go to Adelaide and compete for a $10,000 winner-take-all prize.
So is that a new innovation, or has it been around for a couple of years?
No, this is the first year, supported by the Reventon Group, of course. And as part of that package, the ABSC is providing the cue ball TV coverage at each of these Reventon ranking events.
So cue ball TV, has that been, you know, up and running in Australia for a while, or?
Well, Dan's the man to ask, of course, but over about the last 5 years, and 9 years, sorry. I'm a little deaf in my left ear. But yeah, it really has, it's developed over the years, and you know, you can obviously see now the package that Dan puts together is world class.
Well, I know the commentary is today, so.
Yeah, I'm trying to look around to see who can take over from me.
Yeah. So back to live action now, frame 4, the semi-final here. No score as yet.
It's a red that's potable, but there's really not much value in taking that on for Peter, so I think it might be a shot to nothing even. It might be a take a shot to screw back. And it didn't work out for him.
So it makes a difference, as I would have thought. It was either a safety or a all or nothing pot.
That's right, yeah. But there really wasn't much of a positional shot to get on a colour available.
So Matthew Bolton, probably best known for his billiards acumen, but the last number of years, you know, concentrating more on snooker.
He has worked hard on his snooker. It's really, I suppose I'd say the last 5 years he's concentrated on snooker and he's gotten himself up. So he's been about the only person, I think, that has held the number one ranking in both billiards and snooker, along with Steve Miffs, that actually did get to the top rank of billiards 1 year. So Steve and Matthew, the two standout players.
Is Matthew still going overseas for the World Billiards Championships and events?
We'll have to see about that. There's an interesting situation at the world level in billiards at the moment, which is a political situation, let's say. And as with all political things, it's really doesn't really bring much good to the game. The less said about it, the better, I think. We have the Australian National Billiards next week. We've got a huge field of 48 entries for that, which is almost double what we've had in the past. So it's a fantastic result there for billiards. And we're over at the Yarraville Club, and I think we'll see Dan over there as well with Cubeball TV.
So Matthew's, what, 15 times national champion?
11 times of the national timed event. There's also the 150 up event that I'm, off the top of my head, I'd say he's won about 8 times.
So in that tournament, who would be his main challenges?
We've had, in the final, Michael Pearson from New South Wales has been a good developing player. He's gotten in front of Steve Miffs in the last couple of years in his billiards. Another one to watch in future years, I think he's still only about 17 years now, is Joshua Burns from Tasmania. I noticed a little post on Facebook yesterday, he made his first 200 break in billiards yesterday. So he's one to watch for the next couple of years.
Yeah. And I spoke to you earlier on the beginning of the tournament and asked who you're your tips for with this tournament, and you did mention Matthew, putting you on the spot.
Well, I mean, it is fairly obvious to pick the defending champion as one of the hopefuls. Massive kick there.
Yeah. So how's the game developing in Perth here? I know since I left and come back, there's still a lot of the same faces.
We have a lot of new faces around. It's a tough environment at the moment, obviously with financial pressures. The people just can't go out and go and have a social night every week. So times are changing and times are a little tough, but you know, these tournaments are very well supported. And, you know, WA has 3 players in the top 10 on the national ranking list, so we're obviously doing something right.
So is there any young players coming through at underage level?
Well, Kyle Renton you would obviously pick out as our young hopeful. He won the Australian Under 15 Championship last year. He's turned 15 already, so he's ineligible for it this year. we'll see how he goes in the under-18s, which is just next month in Adelaide. And of course we've got Ben Foster from Geraldton, who was runner-up at the Oceania Under-21 Championship, and I think semi-finalist at the Australian Under-21 Championship. So again, WA really performing well amongst the other states.
So on the national scene, we've got the West Coast International obviously now. What's the coming events over the next couple of months?
Well, aside from the National Billiards, which starts next Saturday, there's the Lance Pannell Memorial, which is at Yarraville Club, following on from the billiards. And then off the top of my head, I think it's back to Adelaide for the Pop Black Open. And then the Fred Osborne at the Albury Commercial Club, followed by the Australian National Snooker in August.
It's our packed schedule.
It's coming into the peak season for the national events, yeah. Little double.
Yeah. Peter McCullagh's been quite a fine ambassador for West Australian snooker since coming over a number of years ago.
Yeah, it took us a long while to get us to convince him that he should go and compete in the at the national level. He's, you know, we've always called him he's the nicest guy in Australian snooker. You will never hear him say a bad word, full stop. Saying that, he can, with a cue in his hand, there is not a single person going around that he couldn't beat. Mm.
When he's in amongst the balls, he's just a very smooth operator, isn't he?
Absolutely, yeah. His cueing is something young kids should just watch over and over and just dream about it, being able to play so smoothly.
You know, his tempo doesn't change whether he's 40 behind or 40 in front.
That's right, yeah. You'll never see him get ruffled or anything. Float the ball out onto the pin.
So a good opportunity here for McCullagh to level things up at two frames each.
That's right, and from where we were looking at possibility of a 3-0 lead for Bolton and then a session interval, that makes it a very different story.
So So has McCullagh ever made the final of the West Coast International?
Off the top of my head, I don't think so. No, we've Adrian Ridley, who's missing from the draw this year, has always performed well here. Mm-hmm. So he's usually in the final if he's here. Matthew Bolton, the defending champion.
He'll be the first West Australian winner for a while.
It was, actually, yeah.
Table in the fourth frame, looking to go four frames ahead.
Yeah, people can't quite see the top of that scoreboard there. The score's 59 to 27. So it's a 32-point lead for Sean. With, looks like two reds left on the table, I think. Could be wrong.
There's still a couple more reds here required by McCullagh.
45 in front, still with five reds on the table, so that's 67 available. So two reds and colours should clean it up.
So is that the first 50 break? I think it is of this semi-final.
I'll have to take your word for that. I've been doing paperwork before I came here.
I think I've been error-free so far, except when I said that the red would pass the yellow and they were actually going for the yellow. So we just nick off the red there, remain on.
Yep, back for the pick.
So, two frames apiece, turns into a best of five semi-final.
That's right. Deja vu of our state championship final last week, which went down to the wire at 6-5. Funnily enough, it was the same referee, Janine Rowlings, for that final.
I must say there's been some very hard-working referees throughout this tournament. Janine Rowlings, Mike Van Deen. I think they haven't had too many rests on them.
Mike Rendell.
Mike Rendell, sorry.
Name check you there. Mike was the one who finished up at 11:30 last night. And a few new faces to refereeing have shown some interest, with young Sophie Crichton, the young, nearly 19-year-old young lady who's showing interest in refereeing. It's amazing, and it's a great thing for the game.
So as we just see Sean Budd now take what looks like an almost unassailable 4-0 lead.
And on our table we have a session interval after four frames. So we'll take a short break and we'll be back in about 10 or 15 minutes. Thank you.
two over. Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you.
Jesus.
I Thank you. I 16.
That's what we're talking about.
I 65. Well done.
I
One.
5:15.